नमस्कार दोस्तों, आपका स्वागत है आपके अपने YouTube चैनल रैंक वाइज एमएस में। और मैं आपके लिए लेकर के आया हूँ BSNL और MTNL से जुड़ी हुई बहुत ही खास न्यूज़। तो दोस्तों, मैं आपको बता दूं कि BSNL की सैलरी फरवरी के बाद में अब अगस्त मंथ की सैलरी 20 दिन लेट आई है। वहीं अगर सेप्टेम्बर मंथ की सैलरी देखी जाए तो नियत समय पर आने की संभावना बहुत ही कम है, क्योंकि BSNL को कोई भी फंड सरकार के द्वारा रिलीज़ नहीं किया गया है अब तक, और ना ही भविष्य में BSNL को लिए फंड अलॉट होने की संभावना है, क्योंकि जो रिवाइवल प्लान है उसके अंदर फंड को शामिल नहीं किया गया है, ओनली 4G के लिए ही फंड शामिल किया गया है। वहीं रिवाइवल प्लान को भी धीरे धीरे डिले किया जा रहा है और अभी तक इसके बारे में कोई भी न्यूज़ नहीं आई है। और क्या कारण है कि रिवाइवल प्लान डिले हो रहा है, इसकी डिटेल न्यूज़ देखेंगे आज हम इस वीडियो में। तो दोस्तों, सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए आपके वीडियो के नीचे दिए हुए रेड कलर में जो लिखा हुआ है सब्सक्राइब SUBSCRIBE, उसको प्रेस करिए और घंटी के निशानों कर दीजिए ऑल पर सेट। ये एकदम फ्री है, मुफ्त है, निःशुल्क है और जीरो इसका सब्सक्रिप्शन चार्ज है। तो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो विदाउट एनी डिले।
In its 18-year history, the company is not able to provide salary to about more than 1.5 lakh employees. So what leads to this crisis?
Yeah, I would like to say that the Modi government has followed the pro-corporate policy that affects the public sector BSNL. For the past 18 years, BSNL could make payment to their own employees without any hindrance at all. But now, BSNL is facing a financial crisis. There is a crunch, financial crunch I can say. Why the financial crunch has come? It is the question. Because in the telecom sector, only 4 big telecom providers are there. One is BSNL, it's a public sector company. Another one is Reliance Jio. Another one is Airtel. Another one is Vodafone. Up to 2014, BSNL was earning profit. From 2016, BSNL went on loss. Not only BSNL, Airtel went on loss. Vodafone went on loss. Why? It is because the entry of Reliance Jio. One company, one private company, Reliance Jio has entered, and they have actually swallowed the subscribers with the patronage of Modi government. They got all support from the Modi government. I can say it's a crony capitalism, because they have got a nexus between the government, Modi government, and Reliance Jio. They got all concessions. That is why BSNL went on loss for the past 5 years. It amounted to 31,000 crores in the past 5 years. Our earning has come down. Not only BSNL has come down, Vodafone came down, Airtel also came down. So this is the crisis we are facing. The crisis is made by the because of the government policy. They are following the pro-corporate policy. That is why we are facing this crisis. We are fighting with the government policies and we are trying to improve BSNL in India.
So is this crisis made by just this NDA government or the previous UPA government's policies also, you know, leads to this crisis?
Definitely I can say UPA government also played their role. But their role is less when comparing this NDA government. See, for an example, I can quote one or two examples. Reliance Jio, they have entered in India in 2016 on September. They told when they enter, their advertisement came in the newspapers and TV channels. Who the ambassador was, you know, it is our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi. He told, use Reliance Jio products. So naturally, people will think that Reliance Jio will get the support of the Modi government. BSNL is the NDA government's company, but they did not give any advertisement to BSNL, number one. Number two, not only giving advertisement, number two, Reliance Jio introduced entry offer as a free, everything free. They have entered. They say that it's a welcome offer. There is a government order, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. They say that you can give free only for 90 days, 3 months. So October, November, December 2016, it is over. Again, as a new year offer, Reliance Jio introduced again a free offer, another 3 months. the free means government will lose money, because when the private operators, they are working, they are selling their product, means they have to pay the license fees to the government, and whatever the revenue they get, they have to share with the government. When it is free, means government will not get. So it is against the law. Then TROI, one DOT secretary, Mr. J.S. Deepak Misra, wrote to TROI chairman stating that it is complete violation what Reliance Jio is doing. So we have to take action, otherwise government will lose money also. That file went and the file came back. You will not believe that the J.S. Deepak Misra, the DOT secretary who wrote the letter, was transferred. So the hurdle was removed, another secretary was appointed, then naturally they gave another 3 months free. In terms of, we can say, it's called a predatory pricing. You know, I can tell you an example, this pen is 10 rupees. If I sell it for 5 rupees, it is called predatory pricing. It is the predatory pricing will kill the opponents. So in the world itself, people will not accept predatory pricing. But in India, Reliance Jio did predatory pricing, not only predatory pricing, they did no cost pricing also. So naturally, as a human psychology, when it is free, people will go for it. So they grabbed the subscribers in the country. They get more. And number two, they got an advantages from the government also. Number two, they approached the government. They said, Reliance Jio told the Prime Minister office that they have to reduce the inter-usage charges. That inter-usage charges means if any network, I am using BSNL network, you are using Reliance Jio, you are calling me, then Reliance Jio has to pay 14 paisa per minute to BSNL. This is inter-usage charges. It's a vice versa also. But Reliance Jio entered late, so their subscriber base is less. So they have to pay more IUC charges. So they went to government, you reduce it. Airtel earlier went, government did not agree. Vodafone earlier went, government did not agree. But Reliance Jio went, now the government agreed to that. They have reduced from 14 paisa to 6 paisa per minute. At a stroke, government lost 5,000 crores. At a stroke, Reliance Jio got the total benefit. So that is why Reliance Jio could grab the subscribers throughout the country. In the March 2019, this Reliance Jio, they have added 1 crore subscriber in 1 month. And 76 lakhs of connections from Vodafone. 26 lakhs of connections from Airtel. And in this situation, BSNL gave 3.5 lakhs connection as a positive one, number one. Number two, why BSNL is suffering? The suffering is due to the non-expansion, and especially the government did not allot 4G spectrum to the BSNL. Three companies, they are having 4G spectrum. In the competition means there will be equal footing. Everybody says that in the privatization, if you say equal footing should be there, where is the question of equal footing for BSNL? BSNL, still now, we have not been allotted 4G spectrum at all. Reliance Jio is having, Airtel is having, Vodafone is having. They are giving the services to the public, but we cannot give the service to the public. As a union, we have demanded this allotment of 4G spectrum to BSNL. We have demanded with the government. We went on strike for 3 times. Every time the telecom minister will give assurance that 4G spectrum will be allotted to you. They have not allotted. On February 2018, they assured us it will be given within a month's time, 4G spectrum. They did not give. Again, we gave a strike notice on December 3rd, indefinite strike throughout the country from Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari. We gave a call. Minister invited us. All the topmost bureaucrats were there. In front of them, they gave it in writing that they will give 4G spectrum to BSNL. And in the parliament, they will say that they will give. If anybody raises a question, they will say that, yes, we are going to give 4G spectrum to BSNL. But still, we are lacking behind. So non-allotment of 4G spectrum, we could not expand our business. And one more pathetic condition, the government is crippling us. Number one, Reliance Jio, they have invested 1,50,000 crore rupees. Out of which, they got bank loan 1.25 lakh crores. That's from the nationalized bank, they got loan. So only 25,000 crores they have invested, they have started the business. Today, I am talking about 2016, 1.5 lakh crore. Today, Reliance Jio's debt is 2 lakh crores. And what about Vodafone? 1,20,000 crores. Airtel, 1,13,000 crores. These huge debts are there from the nationalized banks. If they did not pay, means bank will go bankrupt. Bad debts will increase. But BSNL is having only a loan of 10,000 crores. So for the expansion of BSNL, we ask the government, you give bank loan to us also. For that, we need a letter of comfort. That government has to give it to us. 20,000 crores or 30,000 crores as a bank loan we would like to get. But government did not give letter of comfort to us at all. Our asset, BSNL asset, as per the market value, it is 4 lakh crores. It is our asset. In our corporate office, we have got a building. Our own building, they have assessed is the one building costs about 2,500 crores. So we got an asset and we got a vacant land also. So we asked the BSNL management, asked the government, we have got vacant lands are there. We can monetize it. You please permit us. They wrote a letter in 2018 after the board decision. And our assessment is 1 lakh crore worth of vacant land is there. It went to government. Government returned the file. They say that the land is not in the name of BSNL. It is in the name of Department of Telecom. So we are deprived of everything. The crisis created by the BSNL is the reason for non-payment of salary. But regular employees, their salary was delayed in February and paid on March 15th. And every month they say that this month you will get salary, this month you will get salary. Like that every month they are saying. Our employees are anxious after 20th whether they will get this salary for this month. Every time 20th or 22nd, government will say, no, you will get salary this month. But 1 lakh contract laborers are working here. There is no recruitment from 1984 in BSNL. Very few cadres, very few junior telecom officer, very few they have recruited. For the past 25 years, hardly about 5,000 or 10,000 people will be recruited. So there is no recruitment at all. There are a number of vacancies are there. So they are recruiting contract laborers. And we have got B graduates working as a contract laborer in BSNL. Their salary is maximum 10,000. Minimum is 6,000. Throughout the country they are working. But for the past 5 months, they did not pay to the contract laborers. This is the crisis, number one. And number two, government is not allotting money. BSNL is having 1 lakh towers throughout the country. In Tamil Nadu alone, we have got more than 6,000 towers are with us. 8,000 towers are with us. 550 towers have been disconnected now due to non-payment of electricity bill. What is the total amount of the electricity bill? It hardly about 10 lakhs rupees. If you pay 10 lakhs rupees, it will run. But now they have disconnected. And we have been asked to buy diesel to run the towers, and for purchasing diesel also, they are not allotting money. So in front of public, our service is affected. And they are grumbling about the BSNL service. It is the major reason because of the government policy at all. Policy. As a BSNL employees union, we have mobilized all unions and executive associations also. We went on strike from February 18th to 28th, demanding all these things. But the they say that only after the new government comes, it will be revived. And they say that there are so many rumors are coming, revival plan will be there. Number one point, they said they will close BSNL. It is not possible to close BSNL. Number two, they said to revive BSNL, they want to cut size the employee strength. At the moment, 1.75 lakh regular employees are working. They want to cut size. They want to introduce two schemes. Number one scheme is reducing retirement age from 60 to 58. If it is done this year, 35,000 employees will go in one stroke. And they wanted to introduce VRS system also, voluntary retirement scheme. They say that they want to make healthy BSNL. Our argument is if they cut size the employee strength and make it healthy and they wanted to sell it to the private, that is the government policy. So we are opposing VRS. and we are opposing reducing of 58 days also. In this situation, we are now we are fighting with the government.
How do you think the second term of NDA government is going to affect the company?
I think it will affect 100%, because there is a plan by the government. They wanted to sell BSNL to Reliance Jio. How they will sell? Number one, they will reduce the work strength. Number two, as a strategic partner, they will sell. We have got an example in India. For an example, one company was there, one public sector company was there. Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited, VSNL. It was in Chennai also. 26% of shares have been sold to Tata. Tata bought it as a strategic partner. 1,440 crores rupees he gave it to the government and he bought it. Within few years, he sold his all shares. 50% of the shares he sold on a stroke, 6,000 crores. So four times he got benefited. After a few years, slowly they sold 100% shares. Now in the public sector limited companies, BSNL is not there. Yeah, Tata Telecom Service is there. Like that, they wanted to give a BSNL as a strategic partner to Jio. Jio will be introduced as a strategic partner to BSNL. They will come and they will take over. This is the government's game plan. We want to oppose it. We want to oppose it because this BSNL is a public's asset. It's an Indian public asset. It has been formed more than 100 years. And it has got assets throughout the country. And it's a major, as you said, it's a major public sector in India. These public sectors should be saved. Once Nehru told, public sectors are like temples. And now the government says public sector should be demolished. This is the difference. So we are fighting to save BSNL.
The public perception about BSNL service is that it's quite bad comparing to other networks. If the BSNL employees trying to do anything about this, or the central government is doing any plans to, you know, renovate the situation?
No, government is not doing, but as a responsible trade unions, we are trying to do certain schemes to improve the services. I can self-critically, I can agree one thing. Our services are little bit inferior because of the government policies. And number two, even on our customer service centers, our people could not answer the customers also. We could not supply. For an example, one customer is asking us, you please provide FTTH connection to our home. FTTH connection is the fiber network. He is asking, but we can't give a connection because we can't buy fiber, optic fiber at all. Now it is the order of the day. Optic fiber has been introduced in India. And they are giving all connections to internet connections they are providing. And they gave advertisement that 100 MBPS will free, 2000 GB every month you can use it as a free. And they charge 999 rupees. Very well, BSNL also can give with lesser rate also. But we have not been allowed to purchase optic fiber. In the customer service center, if a subscriber asks you, please give a connection, then our people will say, sorry, we can't give. Then naturally the customer will be irritated, and these people, our people are trying to say that you speak to customer with a smiling face. With a smiling face, how can I say that I can't give a connection? This is our difficulty, real difficulty. So we are, but what we are doing, what all of the products we are having, we are going to the public and we are asking them to buy and use it. What we are having only we can do that. That we are doing throughout the country. And we have introduced service with a smile, customer delight here, everything we are doing. Company has started to grow in the year 2014 and 15. And our operational, we have got operational profit also in the year 2014 and 15. But after Reliance Jio entry, company went on complete loss. So we have to improve the services. We can do it. If government, our pleas, if the government allot money, if the government permits us to avail loan, if the government allow us to monetize our own lands, BSNL will stand up. And it will be a competitor to any other private operators. In the era, if BSNL is not there, naturally the private operators will increase the tariff. Now they will say everything is less. This is a public sector company. If it is not there, it is the, then they will become the monopoly. They will increase the tariff. It was the history throughout the world. It is proved. Government organization should be there. If it is not, the tariff will go. So we are requesting the public to support us and fight with us so that we can save nation, we can save BSNL.